Welcome to my new calculus channel. My name is John Gabriel. You might recall that some months ago I published a video on my long division algorithm and discussed how to use it only with numbers. I didn't really show the connection between polynomials and several other things which I wanted to discuss but I didn't get around to. That video can be found here. It's called Teaching Long Division and it's in my YouTube channel. So if you go to my YouTube link, you will find it there. There are over 108 videos and this, I suggest you watch that video before you come back and continue with this one. So, well, what does division mean in the first place? A lot of academics don't really understand division. And division is really a process whereby you measure something called a dividend with a divisor. And while most might understand that, what they don't really understand is that you can do it also with partial divisors and also using partial dividends and partial quotients. So it's very important to understand the concept of partial divisors because that's what you use when you perform polynomial division. Okay, so in fact everything you do with polynomial division uses partial divisors, quotients, and dividends. And I'll show you how that works in a moment. But what does it mean to divide? Well, say for example you have a dividend of 6 and a divisor of 3. Then you want to know how many times 3 goes into 6 because 3 measures 6, doesn't it? 3 measures 6. So if you have 6 and you subtract 3 from it 2 times, then you found the measurement. So the measure of 6 is 2 times 3. Okay? So this here is called a divisor. We don't even have to write it like that. We could write it as 1 plus 1 plus 1 divided by 4 plus 2 or any combination here that will give us the dividend and any combination here that will give us a divisor. You could have written 2 plus 1 if you wanted to, or just 3, or over here you could have more combinations. You could say 5 plus 1, and they don't necessarily have to be additions. For example, you could have 12 minus 6, or 10 minus 4, and similarly on this side here, you could have 4 minus 1, which gives you 3. It doesn't matter. Also, what comes on the top here is completely random. You don't have to actually think to yourself, well, how many times does 3 go into 6? It doesn't matter what you put up there. Eventually, everything will adjust. Okay, so let me give you an example of how that works. Let's say, for example, you said you decided to put up here, let's say, 4, right? The number 4. Well, 4 times 3 is 12, yes? And 6 minus 12 is minus 6. And then again over here you decide and say, okay, let's put minus 2. Minus 2 times 3 is minus 6. Oops, done. And 4 minus 2 is 2. So it doesn't matter what you put up here, it will adjust itself as you subtract the products in each step. So it can be negative or positive, it doesn't really matter. And the trick here is to remember that whatever number you choose up here, to choose it close to a product that will equal to the first partial dividend. Okay, so something close to either the 6 or the 4 or the 5 or whatever you have as the first term. And you can switch these around. So for example, if you started off with a partial dividend of 2, you can later on switch to 1. And similarly here, it doesn't matter how you do your calculations. Again, I suggest you go back and watch this video here because it gives you quite a few examples, and I don't want to spend time on those examples again because I've done it there. But this is the method that I devised, and I discovered this a long time ago, in fact, when I was still a child. I think I was either 7 or 8 years old. It's the best way to do long division. It doesn't require you to memorize anything or to learn anything else except to have a good understanding of division. So you'll see that if you go to the internet and to try to follow what they give me a certain size there. For example, this one here, look at this big mess here that you have to remember. Just to divide this number here, 425 by 25, right? You have to go through all this process and learn all this nonsense. Well, you could do that using my method very easily. Let me show you. So if you have 425 divided by 25. So you could write 425 divided by 25. Now, we could split this up into partial divisors. Let's just choose 25. It doesn't matter what you choose here, so long as it adds up to 25. Okay. Similarly, on this side here, let's just choose 400 plus 25. Let's get rid of the top part here. Okay. And they don't have to be two partial divisors. You can have three or four. It doesn't matter how many you have here or here, and it doesn't matter what the partial quotients are here, because there's some. Will always be the correct quotient. Okay. So for example, 20 goes into 40, how many times? 20 times, yes? So you'll have 20 times 20 is 400, right? And 20 times 5 is 100. Okay, and here you'll have 25 minus 100, yeah, which is minus 75. And here again, you can choose any one of these partial divisors to if you want to do using, you don't even have to ask yourself how many times is a partial divisor going. But I'm going to do it because I want to finish this quickly. As you can see, it will adjust. It doesn't matter what you put in here. So if we say 5 goes into 75, that would be minus 1, right? Minus 15, yes? And so we would have minus 15 times this whole value here, and we would continue on until it finally adjusted itself up. But I don't want to do that. I want to get to the answer quickly. So I'm going to do this. I'm just going to choose a number here. If we go back to this size here, we can see what the answer is here. Right? What is the answer? Go up down to the end. Give us the answer, but it's not hard to find, because 425 divided by 25, it goes into 4 times, so it's going to be 16 times, so in fact you don't really have 17, right? So what you need at the top here is we need to get 17. So I'm going to just, because I know already the answer, I'm just going to put a minus 3 here, right? And so minus 3 times 20 is minus 60. We should put minus 75 here, so that's minus 60 and minus 15, right? And of course this here gives us 0, and the answer is 17. So you don't have to do it in any particular way. You can choose any partial quotient you like up here. You could choose plus 2, because it will eventually adjust itself as you move down. Okay? Alright, so now that I've covered that, that's really what division means, yes? Okay, so now, what is the long division algorithm? Is it the same as Euclid's algorithm in which he finds the GCD? No. The GCD is not the same as the long division algorithm. You could take a look at, for example, what they teach at university, which is shown in this particular page, and you see here that this doesn't show any understanding, and it doesn't really explain at all how the division algorithm works. In fact, all it does is just rehash the Euclidean algorithm and give you a basic outline of why the Euclidean algorithm works. But it doesn't give you any understanding, because it doesn't even use the word partial. Let's just double check if it has the word partial. Yeah, you see. So this university professor here doesn't even know of partial divisors of quotients, so this explanation will not give the student a very deep understanding of the long division algorithm. Okay, and similarly, the problem in math world is a little better in that it gives you a long division example, but it doesn't tie it up with these particular polynomial divisions here. It doesn't show you how you can relate these two, and I'm about to show you how to do that. So I'm going to give an example in which this here corresponds exactly to the long division. Okay? So, if we come back here, so we've established that the Euclidean algorithm is not the same as the long division algorithm. We've dealt with this, and we've dealt with that. And now we're going to look at what is polynomial division. Okay. So, let's close this file, this paintbrush here, and go back to what is polynomial division. So in my example, just to make it easy for you, I'm going to show you how to perform this division here using partial quotients, divisors, and dividends. And of course we know that 120 divided by 6 is going to be 20, right? Okay. So if we look at this example here, let's start off with this one here. We could just say, okay, well 3 goes into 54, 18 times. Now remember, you can choose any number you like up here. Doesn't matter. And then of course if we multiply this out, it's going to be 54 plus 54. Yeah? And we do a subtraction, and the subtraction gives us 9 plus 6 minus 3. And again 3 goes into 9 3 times, yeah? And we have 9 plus 9. And then we're gonna have minus 3, minus 3. And that goes into the again, minus 1, and so we're done here because we have 0 left. And of course, 18 plus 3 minus 1 is 20. So we get the right answer. It doesn't matter in what order you do this and what you choose as a partial quotient. Obviously, it's wise to choose something close to the quotient when you divide this partial divisor or this one into any of these so that you can get to the answer quickly. Otherwise, you'll be going up and down until you get the right answer. Okay, and so this example here corresponds exactly to this one here. And I'll show you how. So let's go ahead and do this one here. If we just perform it the way we've normally been taught, then we're going to have 2x squared, yes, and that's going to be 2x cubed plus 6x squared, yeah, and that's going to give us x squared plus 2x minus 3. And similarly here we're going to have plus x, and then we're going to have x squared plus 3x, and we're going to have minus x minus 3, and again up top here we're going to have minus 1, and we're going to have minus x minus 3. Now this example here is exactly the same as this one, with x is equal to 3. So if you put x is equal to 3 there, that becomes 6, and if you put 3 in here, then what you're going to get is 54 plus 63 plus 6 minus 3 divided by 3 plus 3. So this example here corresponds exactly to this one. And it doesn't matter how you do this division. You could have done it the other way around too. You could have started with minus 3. You could have said 3 plus x minus 3 plus 2x plus 7x squared plus 2x cubed. So you can reverse it around. It doesn't matter which of these you pick. Obviously it's good to follow a systematic method where you just use either the constant term or the variable so that you can actually get to the answer faster. But the algorithm adjusts itself, as you can see. If you watch my previous video, I've done other examples there where for the sake of showing you that it works, I've chosen to go back and forth, you know, even switching between the variable and the constant. So you can switch between the variable and the constant partial divisor to get the right answer. Okay, so this is how you perform the polynomial division and why you can actually do it, and these are the reasons. So I hope that you enjoyed this presentation, and that you'll join me again soon for another fine video on this channel. Please click like if you found this enjoyable, and subscribe to my channel so that you can be notified every time that there's a new video uploaded. This is a new calculus channel, and I'm John Gilbert. Till next time, goodbye.